Sisters and brothers, I greet you all in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus the Christ, the one who spoke to John by an exile on the Isle of Patmos, declaring, I am he that liveth. Behold, I was dead, and now I am alive forevermore, and I have the keys of death, hell, and the grave. The marketplace is empty. No more traffic in the street. All the builders' tools are silent. No more time to harvest wheat. Busy housewives cease their labor. In the courtroom, no debate. Work on earth is all suspended as the king comes through the gate. Let us pray. Our Father, our God, speak to us now in the waiting moments of this worship experience, so that our hearts will be strangely warm by your eternal truth. We are thankful that on days like today we can declare, mortals shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds from the mouth of God. Cause therefore the words of my mouth and meditation, our hearts be found acceptable in your sight, for you are our rock, our strength, and our redeemer. Amen. By now, my family, the feelings of fear are giving way to feelings of frustration. As the lockdown extends and the curfew remains in place, as social beings, we are formed and created for the reason to engage each other. But now we must dispense with that, for we are not allowed to experience or engage in the richness of cross-pollination or fellowship. Now today, the hypertensive, the diabetic, the cancer patient are all targeted as asthmatics and those challenged with respiratory issues and other chronic diseases. These groups of people have been strongly advised and admonished to stay at home, all because their safety is important and the safety of each other. In discriminate shopping is disallowed. Hotspots and spontaneous activities are banned within the public domain. The streets are amazingly empty. Business has ceased. And there is a stillness in the atmosphere as our lives are upended by the coronavirus. So much so that on this Palm Sunday, which marks the beginning of the most holy season in the Christian calendar, there are no marches or procession going into the courts of the house of God. And albeit earlier. For we are told in Matthew's opening chapters that when King Herod heard, he was frightened, and all Jerusalem with him. Now, the Matthew evangelist makes it clear that when Jesus entered Jerusalem, the whole city was in turmoil, asking, "Who is this?" Just imagine, sisters and brothers, that more than 2,000 years later, the world is still asking, "Who is this?" Of our souls, don't take My son, my sheep, that is my leader. Yeah.
hard prayer for our brothers and sisters who are killed today. Draw our way closer. It's time to seek the Lord. Most gracious and eternal God, you who are our dwelling place throughout all the generations, we thank you, God, for another Palm Sunday, for sparing our lives to see this day. We thank you, God, for the proclamation of your word. Because, God, we are cognizant of the fact that mortals cannot live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds from the mouth of God. Father, we thank you, God, who have given your word to mortals. And we thank you, God, for Pastor Morrison, who declared your word. God, there is so much going on in our world, in our country, in our personal lives. God, things are coming loose all around. And Father, there is someone right now, God, who is burdened down, who feel, oh God, that they are on the verge of giving up. But oh God, we thank you for speaking your word. And Father, we call them, oh God, to have a defiant praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, that despite how I feel, that though he saved me, though I am stripped, though I am losing everything, I feel that I am hemmed in on every side, Lord, we are still going to praise. Because Lord, you are worthy to be praised, God, the rising of the sun, O God, even unto the going down of the sea, God, your name is to be praised. Our praise of God is not based on what we have or do not have, God. Our praise of God is based on the fact that you are God, that you are faithful. And so, God, despite what we hear on the news, despite, God, we hear what going on even in our own country, Father, we are still going to praise you. God, give us the grace, O God, to have a deliverance grace. God, there's someone right now, God, there are someone right now, God, who needs to be delivered. And O God, like the people, O God, who lie in the streets of that day, O God, as they shout, O God, Hosanna in the highest, Lord, we ask, O God, that will fly up to you right now. Jesus, as you ride through, come see about me. I need you, Lord. I need you right now. God, come see about me. I am weak. I do not know where I'm going to pay my rent, my mortgage. So many things are happening all at once. Oh God, send forth your deliverance. And God, thank you for challenging us to have a deep praise. Because God, even in the midst of all of this, you are still good. You are still gracious. You are still merciful. God, you are still happy. And so, God, may we be characterized not by a push ourselves, to lift up our hands, to walk from our homes, to get outside, to walk around our houses, to walk on our streets and just lift up our voices in praise and adoration to you. Father, we praise you. And may we not allow our circumstances to dampen, to marginalize our praise to you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Praise him. Praise him.
This will I do by thy Lord. Remember.